So your first step will be to take some glassing, which you can order from, this is not wax paper, this is glassing. Never use wax paper. It heats much more quickly than glassing. Glassing is specifically used to ship art. And you'll want to cut it exactly so you can cover the face of your painting and tape it to the back. You don't want any tape to ever touch the painted surface or sides of your painting. So, you'll just measure. I personally use painter's tape because I don't want my clients having a hard time getting my paintings unwrapped. It's not my thing. Okay. So since my glass is a little long on the edges, I'm going to fold it in. It is all taped up with the glassine. See, my friend, it's completely safe and covered. That means nothing is gonna melt into my resin and obscure my painting. Okay, now we're gonna go to our bubble wrap. The opposite way we did it the last time. Y'all following? See, we're gonna do it where we have the open spot open now. We're gonna cover it all in bubble wrap. Nothing is gonna get hit on our painting. It's gonna be perfectly protected. Nobody's touching our baby. No bumping, nothing's gonna mess our baby up. Okay, so I'm gonna flip this. And I'm gonna come over here. So you can see what you're doing. Twister turns, bring it up. there. Make it. Happy that you did so much to protect their painting. Then you take your box, open her up. Across here, across here. And I flip the box over and do the same again on the other side. If I see anything that might even look like a tear in the box, I cover it with packing tape. And then I also take a Sharpie. And if I see any old, like this, any old things like that, I take my Sharpie and I mark it all out. Scrub it all out. And then I take it to my favorite shipping place in Baton Rouge. Best of luck to you all, and I hope you have many packages to ship to your clients.